All right, guys, what's up? Zeus here back with another video, and today we are going to be looking at Knight's test server gameplay. Shout out to Kuroshiro for uploading this video with the test server gameplay. I'm just going to give my initial thoughts on it. I'll leave a link to Kuroshiro's video to the test server gameplay, but I don't think it's a secret already because I already made my analyses on him. Like, I already said my thoughts on him already on Twitter and whatnot. Blatantly, I'll just, like, if you just want to know what I think of him right now, I don't think he's S tier. I don't think he's broken anymore. Like, this is just another fool's gold situation where the trailer makes him look really fucking busted, and then they actually, like, release his details and whatnot, the numbers behind his shit, and then it's like, oh yeah, he's not actually as broken as we thought. So just another fool's gold stitch. I really wish netease stopped doing that, to be honest. I really wish when they release character trailers, they just say like how long this shit lasts, like the cooldowns for the things, etc. 'Cause them doing this really gets annoying, like very fast. It's really just inconvenient. But regardless, we're just gonna watch this through. We're gonna then, get more in depth about it, theorize, etc., and see where, again, if maybe my final standing changes after just watching this in its entirety. So, with all of that being said, let's get started. Put this thing in full screen.
This is Richard Sterling here. As we can see, this is his 360-degree view. We're gonna have a good overview of him since he is
Talk to
currently
me,
in test
Kuroshiro.
server
Talk to
right
me,
now.
you. Talk to me.
First and foremost, let's talk about his skill. For Knight, he has this skill called Adaption, in which he immerses himself into story mode and he takes the traits of Knight.
So
Now,
he's
what
Arthur from
effect
Fire
will he
Force.
be
That's
able to
funny.
render? As
If
you
you
can
know,
see
you
in the
know.
bottom left-hand side of our screen, if we just press it, you can see there's an ability button, an attack button, and a stalemate button. Of course, for each one of these, you can use your adaption when you are within 13 meters near the
When you're
hunter.
about to get screwed
Right,
over.
so right now the hunter is not close to us just yet, so we can't do anything. So we'll get the hunter to actually walk towards us. And you can see on the bottom right-hand side of your screen, adaption slowly but surely comes into, like, it starts lighting up as you can see there. So adaption, no adaption. Adaption, no adaption. If we use it outside of range, it just says that there's no targets within the range for tactical force.
Oh, that's really dumb. Yeah, that's really stupid. I'm not gonna lie. That's really dumb. 'Cause that just means now Hunter's like BQ. They just treat him like an anti. They just need to. They just be far away from him, and mirror or some shit or like other character. Ah, that's really stupid. Oh my god. That also entails that you can then bait it out like an officer watch since it's an item. Oh my god.
We'll now talk about his skills. So, what is Knight's skills? The first one is his ability skill. If the hunter uses an ability and he gets predicted within the next 8 seconds, the hunter skill will be nullified. So we just test it out here. So we
Only lasts 8 seconds. So you have 8 seconds to predict maybe two things. Yeah.
press one and we try out the skill. As you can see here, the hunter is nullified. He can't use
So that
any
should give
more
you a
skills
speed
for the
boost,
next
right?
6 seconds. And the ring has disappeared. Now, what is the next skill? If we just enable the cooldown depletion here, is the attack skill. If you manage to successfully bait out the attack or predict attack, then the hunter will get stunned. And you'll get a 40% movement speed boost. So we'll just do it here. And we'll do that. Here, as you can
Yeah.
see, there's a 40% movement
That
speed
that's
boost,
not
and there
bad.
is the
That's good.
hunter
That like
being
that's good. Like
stunned. So
that's
he basically just inspects his equipment. We'll try this again.
inspecting the
And I
equipment.
will spam the attack button, by the way. So we press two, and then I spam the attack button. Here, as you can see, the hunter cannot hit until 4 seconds are over, or it's 3 to 4 seconds, but it's around that. Hunter can't two,
Rip.
and then I spam the attack button.
Oh, wow.
Here, as you can see, the hunter cannot hit until 4 seconds are over, or it's 3 to 4 seconds, but it's around that.
Okay, that's
Now,
not.
the next one is stalemate. You actually can't use stalemate by itself. I'm spamming the stalemate button 3 right now, but you actually cannot use it by itself. You have to either use a prediction first and then stalemate. in which what stalemate does is if the hunter does not do any animation or any attack or ability, you gain a shield. And with the shield, you counter a chip damage. You just take a chip damage.
So, oh my god. So, the third part of his ability, that is still a gamble, by the way. You have to get the prediction. You still need to predict it. You need to guess ability or attack first before you can even use stalemate to get that chip. So I'm assuming now that that means that if you get the shit wrong, you can't even use stalemate. Unless I'm proven otherwise in the video. That's... Jesus, fuck.
You do see here too. So like, with the hunter, let's try predict the hunter using an ability.
Uh-huh.
And then using a basic attack. So we'll use an ability first. As you can see, it gets countered. And we use a basic attack, you get a movement speed boost. Right?
Mm-hmm.
On the other hand, if we predict that the hunter will use his attack and then stalemate, we can say, okay, we're going to try basic attack here. Oh, but the hunter is currently stunned and we're still right now running. Stalemate will still be active and you still just tank a chip damage. So this works, generally speaking, pretty well.
If Wait.
You are active and you still just tank.
The thing has a timer. The chip hit has a timer.
There's currently stunned and we're still right now running. Stalemate will still
Wait. Oh my god. It's not even useful. Okay, let me not say that before someone clips that shit out of context and like says it's not that useful. It's not. Because now all that means now is that you just need to wait 4 seconds. If you're that concerned with the stalemate chip hit, wait 4 seconds and that's it, it goes away. Look at that shit in the corner. Look in the upper left.
And you still just tank a chip damage. So this works.
It goes away after 4 seconds.
Close to the hunter. Against Gamekeeper, it might just be a little bit.
So it's not even.
Okay, now let's look at Richard Sterling from the hunter's point of view. So here we have Bloody Queen. We are going to try his ability button first.
Mm-hmm,
so
what
I'm going to utilize Richard Sterling's ability.
My boy Richard Sterling, Knight here Sterling. I'm going to call him that from now on, Knight Sterling. That's his new name.
The mirror immediately gets nullified.
Everyone from here on out, you shall refer to him as Knight Sterling.
And he's really, really, really safe. Now let's try basic attack hit. So we predict.
Uh-huh. And boom.
You're basically nullified for quite a while. With the basic
But it is about 3 to 4 seconds.
Twice with a prediction here. So that's number one. That's number two.
Oh, and it's question mark.
Basic attack number one, you can't do anything. That's basic attack number two, and he basically still gets that movement speed buff. Now, let's see it from the hunter.
But my thing is this. You as the hunter, you can just choose to not do anything. Like, this is a game of rock, paper, scissors, but where the hunter wins by not playing. Like, you're not required to do anything. It lasts for only the fairy tale like foreplay bullshit. It lasts for only 8 seconds. While he's doing his guessing game bullshit, you just only need to wait 8 seconds, and then his ability is useless. And then if you're like, oh well, he'll just guess stalemate. The chip only lasts for 4 seconds. The max you'll have to wait is 12, maybe 16 if he'll do like 2 stalemates back to back. But even then. The max you'll have to wait is 12, because I don't think the chips stack on top of each other anyway. Like, this is a lot of people, a lot of those that I'm gonna blatantly say it, a lot of the hunter players were bitching and moaning when they saw this character on release, when they saw the character in the test server, not the test server, on Twitter and on thing, because he has this, he has that, he has this, he has that, he has this, he has that, with disregard to whatever excess bullshit he can have. I'm not gonna deny that there were some also like smart ass survivor players that were like, actually the game is actually unfair for the hunter, so they need to actually nerf this character. Even though they peaked at like elk or mammoth. But it's like there's so much like it's such simple shit. Like this is not gonna be hard and difficult in the slightest. He uses his ability, walk away. That's it. Walk away. He uses the ability, just don't do anything. And even if he gets that little fucking shield, it lasts for 4 seconds. Like, I don't know. Like, he looked so good on paper. And then you see what they did with him. And now he's like, He's not even like high A tier for me now. Knowing like I thought the shield at least lasts just guaranteed for like a chip or something. Like, and granted, it can be used in like a puppeteer kind of situation where you're just waiting for the hunter to like get close. So it's not completely useless, like I said. It's just not as useful as I thought it would be, because it's just a worse puppeteer. That's what it is. It's literally just a worse Lewis.
Point of view with stalemate. So we'll use ability and then we will use stalemate. So here's the ability, it gets locked, and then here is stalemate where he gets his mini shield and he only takes a chip damage.
Sadly, that thing only lasts for
And
4 seconds.
that knight's chivalrous sympathy in which he can rescue the survivors of.
This is the greatest thing about him so far. I want to see what they do with this because there's a lot of things. I wanted to know if you could go through walls, if you have to be directly looking at the chair, etc. Let me just. Knight can activate chivalrous sympathy on a survivor within 8 meter who is within 8 meters. On a survivor within 8 meters who is on the rocket chair, allowing the survivor to break free. Activating chivalrous sympathy for the first time will grant both the knight and survivor a chivalrous sympathy effect. After successfully rescuing a teammate, both the knight and rescued survivor are emboldened, reducing the fear generated by the next instance of damage taken by half for the next 8 seconds. Well, it's good. It's still good. It's just you gotta be within journalist
Rocket here
range.
and allow them to tank a chip damage for the next 8 seconds. Right now, Bulma will cheer this perfumer, and on the bottom right hand side of our screen, we should be able to see an or button here for chivalrous
Wait, why is it
sympathy.
not?
So if you're in the right angle, if you're in
You
the
have
right
to be
angle.
looking at the survivor. Oh my. Sorry. excuse me. You need to be direct. You need to. Oh my God. That's so bad. That's so bad. That's so bad. That's so bad. And I say that's bad because now it's like that. That's just extra shit that doesn't need to be a thing. Like, it's not the worst thing ever. Like, I'm exaggerating it just a tad. It's not the worst thing ever. But it's
We're
just. It's
using walls
annoying.
behind walls, so we'll just use this for now. Now, please do remember that I did bring Tightener here, so let's also see if Tightener comes into effect or
Yes,
not here.
thank you. One of the big questions.
And once we get the
It
rescue, it seems
does.
like both
Okay.
Perfumer and Knight has
Perfect.
Tightener. And if I hit Perfumer here, Perfumer only takes a
Your chip
chip damage, so
damage.
just have that in mind too. There's one thing that you have to be really careful about Chivalrous Sympathy is the fact that you can actually get Terror Shocked if you mistime it, because this is considered an animation. So right now I'm gonna
Yes.
press Bomb on basic attack alongside with his rescue ability, and you will see him be able to get Terror Shocked. There we go. So you need to be very careful in
That
that rescue
animation is short
ability.
though. It is
This
pretty
ability
short.
is, you know,
So for the
pretty
hunter to
nice
terror
in
shock
terms of
you.
activation time, but if you don't use it correctly, then you will get Terror
Yeah.
Shocked.
So
Now,
that's the
here is one
trade-off.
thing about Knight's tactical foresight. So when Knight begins rescuing a teammate, his tactical foresight will disappear. Okay, so let's just do this here, right? If we drop down coordinator on towards the chair, and we're gonna tactical foresight here, predict that the hunter will use his abilities twice, and we get Bomb on here to use his ability, as you can see, it does get immediately locked, and you can perform the rescue. So
Oh.
here comes the big issue. If you predict your ability button, and you want to rescue and you let go, Bonbon can still use his item. So just know that he's very.
His ability gets animation canceled like Officer, except you can't refresh it.
Similar to First Officer with his abilities, if you, let's say, use ability, but then you decided to rescue, Bonbon can still put his items down in between that 1 second mark. So just be very careful when it
Okay,
comes to
that niche, I guess.
rescuing Wish Knight alongside with his items. Okay, here's another thing about Knight's chivalrous sympathy. So if Soulweaver actually cocoons a survivor here, as you
And
do
you should be able
see,
to do it,
this means
right? Like
Soulweaver can
that would only
win.
make sense.
Knight can actually rescue survivors in Cocoon. So you just need to press the button.
I was gonna say, I'm like, that
Knight's
only
gonna
makes
give it
sense. He should be
immediately.
able
Actually, he
to.
does tank a chip damage if we just go hit. But
Yep.
it's only a chip damage taken.
The
So
8
if you
seconds is
force
fine.
Soulweaver here, you can actually rescue just like that. No, last but not least, Richard Cerny external trace is all Tom's
15% decoding.
He receives a 15% decoding speed debuff. But that's going to be it here for Richard Cerny in our test server and, you know, against each hunter. Throughout the next 1/2 weeks, we'll be uploading Richard Cerny versus all other hunters and, of course, a guide here for our knight. But of course, everyone, if you enjoyed this video, why not leave a like? Why not subscribe if you're new around here? And hopefully enjoyed. Hopefully you learned something new. I will see you all in the next videos. Bye bye for now.
He needs a buff. I'm just gonna outright say it. He needs a buff. Something. Genuinely speaking, he needs a buff. He's just not. I don't know. For my standards, he's just not good enough. He's all right, but he's just not good enough. Just blatantly speaking. To my standards, maybe when he's allowed in competitive, I'll get proven wrong, but to my standards, he's just not good enough. Like, the only thing he has going for him is the rescuing. Other than that, his whole concept is playing rock, paper, scissors, except the opposing faction has the option to not play and win by not playing. And then, of course, then there's the fact that his cooldown is, what, 15 seconds? That he can't use it for? Yeah. He has a 15-second cooldown on his ability. Okay, 14. Whatever, same fucking shit. So, no, yeah. At that, the actual, like, knight stance only lasts for, what is it, 8 seconds? Let me see if he put it in here. I'm relying on editing you. Yeah. Okay, cooldown 14 seconds. He only has 3 of them, and then yeah, it's only 8 seconds. So yeah, he's just not good enough. Just blatantly speaking, like, he needs a buff or something. Like, he's not good enough. He's gonna get railed. Like, I really thought like he was gonna be like the next anti with how he was in the trailer. And now you just look at it, like, numerically and what he does and, like, how he works, and it's, like, it's not enough. It just blatantly is not enough. Like, I could see, like, maybe the excuse of, like, him being decent for Opera because of the option for the stalemate, and then obviously Opera's mobility is centered around her clicking the button. So when she gets into your range, like, you know that when she gets into your range, she's going to be using her movement. Because she has to use her movement to catch up to you. If she's not using her movement, then she's giving you a free kite. So you will be able to cancel that perfectly fine. So I think against Opera, he has some value in that as a niche pick against Opera. But the issue with tournament is that Opera isn't the only round one viable hunter anymore. There's Ivy who exists, and he is going to get destroyed by Ivy just blatantly, because Ivy has too many things going on for her. And Ivy's whole shit is that she can just M1 walk to you slowly, while the Yif that you cannot, like, manipulate in any way, because that's its own external thing, gets you. Not to mention, the half of her abilities are external. They're not something you can control. Full presence is not something you control. The Yif is not something that is counted as a quote-unquote, like, physical ability. It's just a trait. It's just a part of her. When she swaps to the Yith, it's not like a Dream Witch swap. It's not considered, I guess, quote unquote, a swap back and forth. Because if you're on Yith and you get fireballed by an acro, you don't get forced off, to my knowledge. I could be wrong. I'll fact check that. So take that specifically with a grain of salt. If it works like Dream Witch logic, then shit, okay. He'll have maybe a little bit of something. But he's still just, he's going to be too easy for Ivy to deal with. Opera, he'll have his niches. I'll give him credit for that. Opera, he will have his niches. Ivy, it'll probably just be a 50-50. Goatman is going to be a menace. He's not going to be good against Goatman. He's just not. Goatman has to wait. Goatman doesn't even need to be near him, because that, and like, that's the thing. The reason why I say he's not going to be good against Goatman is because the hunters need to be within a range. So Goatman, with his ability to set up a 15-meter fucking cage just out of thin air, he can just see him from afar, set up the cage from afar, backdash, and then go in front of him and get that fucking hit in. And then from there, it's just, okay, well, what to do, what to do, what to do. Like, that's it. He needs a buff, something. He like it's not he's just blatantly, like, in my opinion, he's just not good enough. He isn't. His rescuing is the only thing he has going for him right now, which is good because he is a rescuer character. You would expect the rescue character to be good. I don't need another journalist situation. But this right here is hard carrying his kit. And it's not even hard carrying by a huge margin because you need to see the survivor's face in order to get it, practically. You can't see their. You have to see the survivor's face to get it. So you practically need to just be in front of the chair, practically speaking. I think one thing I wish is that he tested to see if it goes through walls. Because I wonder if, like, if you, like, you know, like, pixel capture it through, like, a fucking, like, hole in a wall or some shit, and you see the survivor's face through that, like an embalmer can, will that count as, like, the, you know, your condition to rescue? I wish he did that, damn. But no, he's not good enough. He's not. Like, I feel like, for me, like, he's just not good enough. I don't know. Let me know your opinions in the comment section. Let me know why you feel, if you think that I'm wrong so adamantly. Let me know why you think I'm, like, completely wrong and batshit crazy. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this one. I'm really disappointed in Knight, not gonna lie. But I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.